Hello zusammen, I'm your vlog Dave, and I hope you have tossed a coin to your beloved Witcher, yours truly, so to speak, Geralt von Riva. Or Geralt of Rivia, as you might call him. And I hope every one of you also had an earworm, an Ohrwurm, a catchy tune, that's how we Germans say it, der Ohrwurm, from Toss a Coin to Your Witcher. Because that is sort of, well, The Witcher's theme song, if you will. But there is a difference between the English version, Toss a Coin to Your Witcher, and the German version, which you can hear in the German dubbing, the German version of The Witcher on Netflix. And the lyrics are slightly different as well, so, So let's actually find out what the German version translates to in English. This video is mainly based on the linguistic side of things. I'm also gonna talk about the semantics here and there, meaning the meaning. My translation might be quite direct and literal, but purposely so, because I want to show you which German words translate to which English words. Rather than having only a few longer verses, this song consists of many short ones. The first one goes, Als ein Bade einst seinen Weg konnt teilen mit Geralt von Riva entstanden diese Zeilen. As you can see, these lines are semantically interwoven. It's Rittersporn singing here, Geralt's bard companion. Interesting enough, the German name of Geralt refers to the city Riva, while the English name rather refers to the kingdom of Rivia. And if you want to find out more about what all the names and many basic things in The Witcher translate to in German, or what they are called in German in the German version of the series, well, check out this video in the end card. The German conjunction and preposition als can mean both as and when, depending on the context. Here it's meant in a temporal way.
When once a bard.
Something especially poetic and lyrical is the use of an ellipsis. Since The Witcher takes place in a medieval setting, the use of language and certain ways of expressing things got adapted to that context too. Konnt could would usually be konnte in the third person singular preteritum, indicative mode, active, of können, can. The German E at the end of konnte is a typical letter to be dropped at the end or even within certain German words. The German verb entstehen can be translated in various ways, depending on the context and personal preferences. It usually means to develop, to originate, to come into existence, to begin, to occur, or whatnot. Also, you might have noticed that it's only lines 2 and 4 that rhyme, which is common for the song as a whole. Not everything rhymes exactly, like with the exact same endings of words, but they still have a rhyming quality to them. In general, Rittersporn's occupation of being a fictitious bard also reminds of real medieval Minnesänger, der Minnesänger, singular, die Minnesänger, plural, the minstrel or minnesinger. They were really common in German territories back then. And by the way, Minstrel in the Gallery is a great song and a great album by Jethro Tull. Also, I already mentioned one in the previous Witcher video that I did on this channel, and that was Walter von der Vogelweide. Walter from the Bird Meadow. Yeah. Als der weiße Wolf gegen einen Teufel kämpfte, seine Elfenarmee dabei vor seinen Hufen schwenkte. The German lyrics make use of an indefinite article as opposed to a definite one. An example for a definite article would be der. Der Teufel, the devil, which specifically refers to the one and only, yours truly, so to speak. An indefinite article could be ein Teufel, a devil, like just some random devil out of many different ones existing. Because in The Witcher's world there are a lot of monsters and one devil or devilish creature is nothing exciting at all. The compound term Elfenarmee would equal Elf's army in English. However, army of elves might come closer to what that would be expressed like in English. It's der Elf, singular, die Elfen, plural, the elf, and die Armee, singular, die Armeen, plural, the army. Just gonna mention, all the lyrics you see here are written in the preteritum tense. That's a German tense which basically equals the simple past in English. So everything is told from the past perspective. So in other words, even though they are really cool still to this day, all the mentioned Abenteuer, das Abenteuer Singular, die Abenteuer Plural, the adventure, well, they have already happened. But to this day, they tell of Geralt's Ehre, honor. Sie verfolgten mich mit meisterlicher List, brachen die Laute, traten in mein Gesicht. So this time the verse is written from Rittersporn's perspective, the bard's perspective. The verb verfolgen, here verfolgten for the third person plural, preteritum, indicative mode active, means to follow. Since the context rather implies it's sort of a hunt, though, die Jagd, for Geralt and Rittersporn, I also chose that more aggressive term. To hunt is jagen in German, by the way. And now that I think about it, isn't Rittersporn quite a young man still? And don't all the lyrics deal with things that have happened a long time ago in the past? Does he actually know what he's singing about? I mean, I wouldn't go as far to call him a likable Lügner. Der Lügner, singular, die Lügner, plural, a liar. Because, yeah, he is likable and he actually does something musically that is really cool in my book. Someone's gotta do the job, I guess. Als des Teufels Hörner unser Fleisch aufspießten, sagte der Hexer, man darf sein Blut nicht vergießen. This is a good example of how Germans use Fleisch, das Fleisch, and context-based, well, everyone knows which one is meant, whereas in English you'd rather distinguish between flesh, human flesh, and meat, animal meat, the one you eat. Well, that rhymed as well. I almost feel like a bard right now.
Animal meat, the one you eat.
Typically German, we would create a compound word which specifies the type of flesh or meat we're talking about. For instance, das Pferdefleisch, horse meat, or das Schweinefleisch, pig meat. Now, the last line could be interpreted in ambiguous ways. First of all, whose blood are we talking about here? Man darf sein Blut nicht vergießen. You must not spill his blood. So is it the Witcher's blood or is it the Devil's blood? Imagine we're talking about the Devil's blood here. This could mean or this could lead to many different interpretations, I think. For instance, you should not spill the Devil's blood because it might be cursed and do even more harm afterwards. Or you should not spill the Devil's blood because it's simply not worth the violence and too dangerous. Or you should not spill the Devil's blood because even though the devil is evil, Geralt has a kind heart, and so on. He leaves him alone. He doesn't want him to suffer without good reason, in a way. So I don't know, what do you think suits Geralt and his attitude most? And to whom does this refer? I think it's worth noting that up until this point, we haven't even heard the chorus yet. But hey, here it comes. Didn't see that coming. Literally.
Reichet Gold eurem Hexer, ihr gütigen Menschen, do it.
As you can see, the quite literal English translation here is really close to the English version of the song, but it's not completely samey or similar. We don't really have a really exact equivalent to the English saying to toss a coin to someone in German. Basically, to give someone some money in order for them to do something. Basically, a donation or pledge. By the way, talking about that. So, I heard you find my videos helpful, entertaining, and you really enjoy them?
Well, thank you very much in the first place.
The crowdfunding page Patreon is definitely one of the best ways to say thank you, Dave, and to support me. Honest, heartfelt thanks for doing that, because every little bit helps. Thanks for your attention, and now enjoy the rest of the video. Translated literally, it would equal werft eurem Hexer eine Münze zu, throw your witcher a coin, meaning to him. For die Münze, singular, die Münzen, plural, the coin, and to toss, werfen or zuwerfen. The German verb jemandem etwas zuwerfen features the prefix and preposition zu, at or to, in zuwerfen. Am Rande dieser Welt bekämpfte das Horn, es plagte und schlug euch und brachte nur Zorn. The E at the end of Rande, which usually is der Rand, singular, die Ränder, plural, the edge or border, is a good example of something that nowadays Germans would consider very dated and old-fashioned, and therefore typically poetic or lyrical style-wise. It's a so-called dative E, a dative E, an E that was commonly added to the end of certain nouns to change the verbalization and to highlight its noun in dative. Nowadays, you can't really find too many dative E's in the German language because they pretty much got dropped, but there are a few German words which still feature them regularly. Here, the term das Horn, singular, die Hörner, plural, the horn, is used as a metaphor for the devil as a whole, and it was used for rhyming purposes. Horn, Zorn. Also using euch as a way to address a single person once was a typical polite way of addressing someone, especially someone belonging to royalty or nobleness, someone from high standing so to speak, especially in past centuries and medieval times. For instance, when you want to say your majesty in German, you would say eure Hoheit. You even used this when you knew the person and when that person was close to you in a way. Nowadays, when you know a person or you're talking to a child, you want to use du, you in singular. Gegen jeden Elf kämpfte einst an, weit fort in den Bergen, aus denen kam. A typical German grammatical structure is the separation of verbs and their prefixes, once they are conjugated in phrases or sentences. For instance here, the infinite form of kämpfte an is ankämpfen. Märzte aus die Pest. Hört ihr denn nicht zu? Er ist Freund aller Menschen, drum lasst ihn in Ruhe. Again, we have two ellipses here. Drum would actually be darum, hence or so, and Ruhe would actually be die Ruhe, the silence. And in this context, lasst ihn in Ruhe means leave him alone. And talking about difficult things to translate from German to English, modal particles can be tricky ones too. The term denn in the second line is one. It basically is used for making demands and wishes sound a bit more polite and friendly, if you will. Here, the bard or the lyrical eye really wants you to listen to everything he sings about, but he still wants to say that with some hint of politeness. Das war meine Mär von diesem starken Mann. Bekämpfte das Böse, nun stoßt auf ihn an. The old German term Mär is a really interesting one from a modern point of view. It's a very, very outdated German term which gets associated with medieval times and many centuries ago, because no German would use this term anymore nowadays. You can either translate it to story, which might or might not imply it's fictitious or made up, because a story can be both, maybe even a mixture, some truth and some lies in it. Or you can use it as a shortened form of das Märchen, singular, die Märchen, plural, the fairy tale, which most definitely is a made-up fictitious story then. In that case, it might also indicate a negative connotation, meaning you accuse someone of basically lying on purpose. Apart from one replaced O for another interjection ja, yes, the rest of the song features the repeated chorus. All in all, I think this song really sums up and, well, expresses the atmosphere and the vibe, the mood of the series, so I really like it. And of course, I want to know, what do you think about it? Maybe you know if you liked this video or not. Well, if you did, let me know by leaving a like and leaving a comment and sharing this video with others, with fans of The Witcher and the German language, both maybe. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'm your Vlog Dave. See you next time. Tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.